sermon, you don't look like where you've been. We find these words because, beginning at verse 2. But as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped. For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. For there are no bands in their death, but their strength is firm. They are not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men. And for a sermon, for a topic, I would like to use, it just ain't fair. ASAP.
Yes.
He was disturbed, as many of us have been on many occasions.
Yeah.
He is disturbed because he has seen the difference between the righteous and the wicked. He is distressed, frustrated, aggravated because he observed on many occasions the righteous suffering while the wicked are prospering. He has witnessed the continual success of the ungodly and continued agony and distress of the children of God.
All right.
It got him so great until he said, I almost slipped. When he looked around him and saw the wicked going higher and higher while the righteous was being brought, Lord and Lord, he reported his feet almost slipped. The wicked prosper,
come on,
and the righteous suffer. It just ain't fair. All right. He said, I'm laboring to dot all the right I's, to cross all the right T's, and they still going higher and higher, and I'm going lower and lower. It just ain't fair. I know some of y'all in there saying, you supposed to be saying it just isn't. But I like it just ain't fair. ASAP was a man who lived for God.
Yes,
ASAP was a man who walked and talked with God.
Alright.
ASAP was a child of God.
Right.
See, ASAP was in touch and in tune with the circumstance and the situation in his day and time. He said that good things that came by way of blessing to the children of God, and it remained more easy for the wicked and the ungodly than for the godly.
That's all right.
It just ain't right.
Right.
Asaph saw the ungodly, as many of us in here witnessing our time.
All right.
He saw the ungodly getting all the promotion.
Yeah. Huh.
He saw the ungodly constantly rising from one level of success to another.
All right. All right. Come on, y'all.
And he witnessed the righteous constantly being sought.
Yeah.
Their way being made difficult and hard. He saw the righteous in great disasters. It just ain't fair. It affected him. It had a negative impact on him.
That's right. That's right.
It affected him from the first until his feet almost. The great problem was his focus.
Yes.
I want to talk to somebody in this house today who has observed unfair practice.
Yes. All right.
Who has been victimized by the unfair treatment.
Yes.
I want to talk to somebody. You can't continue to focus on the wicked.
Come on.
see what nobody else got. People get out of their car, stand outside the restaurant, just laughing and talking. They stay out there for 30 minutes or more. Yeah. And sometimes I tell the person I'm with, they ain't home. To God does something in their life. And all of a sudden, they see. tell them about this experience you had when your children were small.
Amen.
When I tell this, I kind of feel embarrassed. So she don't do them a laugh. But see, one time, the kids wanted to go to the fair. So she couldn't take it to the fair. And I never been one for a lot of rap. I have a low tolerance for some of these rap. I could not tolerate some of these rap. Call it motion sickness or whatever. I couldn't handle some of these rap. But my daughter, Zara and Leslie, wanted to do a lot of riding that day. I let them ride everything I could think of. And I walked and I would stand around and I would look. But they said, Dad, look like you would ride something with them. And I said, well, I'll look around and see if I can find something. I looked around the fair and I saw a certain ride. And I thought I could handle it. But here's the problem. I saw it when it slowed down. In spite of your hardship, in spite of your difficulty, it takes faith to fear of that which is empty.
Yes. All right. Jesus, my shepherd. Yeah.